Welcome to Hello English Teacher. Today let's look at the MCQs from the literature section of class 10 English. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. So let's look at the extracts and the MCQs. Here is the first one. Everything was going well. It was an easy flight. Paris was about 150 kilometers behind me when I saw the clouds, storm clouds. They were huge. They looked like black mountains standing in front of me across the sky. I knew I could not fly up and over them, and I did not have enough fuel to fly around them to the north or south. I ought to go back to Paris, I thought, but I wanted to get home. I wanted that breakfast. I'll take the risk, I thought, and flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. So let's look at the questions. Here is the first one. Based on the given extract, choose the option that lists the meme which would be appropriate to the response, "It was an easy flight." So the correct answer here is option C, which says, "You spoke too soon because he yet has a lot to face ahead of him." So now let's look at the next question. How do you describe the risk the narrator took? Calculated, impetuous, unavoidable or navigable? So the answer is impetuous, which means very quick decision without a second thought. So let's look at the next question. In what way might the reference to the old Dakota be relevant? Its unique, its antique value made it expensive and precious to the narrator. It is employed by the narrator as a term of endearment. It did not have enough fuel to fly around the storm. Its ability to negotiate the storm clouds might have been suspect. So the answer is, its ability to negotiate the storm clouds might have been the suspect. So the next question. Read the statements given below and then select the option that best describes the given statement. So statement 1 is, the narrator's desire to reach home and see his family made him complacent. Statement 2 is, the narrator was unaware of the threat that the adversarial storm clouds presented. Statement 3 is, the narrator's decision making was quick but irresponsible as well as dangerous. So let's look at the options. You have to find out which statement is true, which is false and which cannot be inferred, etc. So here the answer is C, which says statement 1 cannot be inferred, statement 2 is false and statement 3 is true. So the next question, select the option to fill in the blanks below. So risk is equal to risky. So that is one set. So risk is a noun and risky is an adjective. So similarly, you have to find the same pair where there is a noun and an adjective. So the correct answer here is B, hazard and hazardous. So let's look at the next extract. Thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys, of designing motorboats. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. At least that's what everybody thought. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could tell almost who it was. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners. Then they would know. So the questions. For the girls, the contest consisted of designing motorboats, designing dresses, designing sceneries or designing forests. So for girls, it was designing dresses. So next, according to the class, the girl who would win the competition was Maddie, Peggy, Wanda or Cian. So all thought that Peggy would win the competition. Maddie thought that Peggy was sure to win the competition because she had the setting with the teacher. She was the teacher's relative. She drew worse than others. She drew better than others. So the answer is, she drew better than others. So most of them thought that she would win the contest. So next question, what is the word in the noun form that you can make from the word win. So is it winnable or winnably, winning or winner? So the answer is winner. So name of the classmates of Wanda are Jacques and John, Peggy and CM, Maddie and Peggy, Maddie and Jerk. So the answer is Maddie and Peggy, who were the classmates of Wanda. So next extract. The way a crow shook down on me the dust of snow from a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So of the many symbols the hemlock tree represents, choose the one that Frost drew up in all likelihood for this poem, symbol of longevity, togetherness, healing or protection. So here it is the symbol of healing. So let's look at the next question. Choose the options that list the possible feelings of the poet prior to the experience shared in this poem. So reassured, disappointed, curious, demotivated, thankful, disheartened, impulsive. So the answers are 2, 4 and 6, which is disappointed, demotivated and disheartened. So before he had the experience of the snowfall, he had these emotions. So next question. Identify the option that does not use the word rue correctly. The film was a disaster and he rued his decision to act in it. I am sure she rued the day she listened to a fortune teller. It wasn't long before I rued my disobedience and my deceit. Others finally rue the one who is dishonest and heartless. So the correct answer is others finally rue the one who is dishonest and heartless. Here the word rue is not used correctly. So next question. Synecdoche is a poetic device that uses a part to represent a whole. Example, that's a great set of wheels. So set of wheels has been used for car. So pick an example of synecdoche from the poem. Has given my heart a change of mood. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree and saved some part of a day I had rued. So the correct answer is has given my heart a change of mood, because the word heart represents the poet. So that's why it's called a synecdoche. So next one, choose the option showing the reason not corresponding with a crow shook down on me the dust of snow. So the options are the crow's landing on the branch of the tree, the shivering of the crow due to cold, the readjustment of the position of the crow on the branch, the cawing of the crow hidden in the foliage. So the last one, the cawing of a crow hidden in the foliage, does not correspond with the meaning of the crow shaking down the dust of snow on the poet. So next extract. I think I knew I made a little money this way, but he did not seem to mind. Anil made by money by fits and starts. He would borrow 1 week, lend the next. He kept worrying about his next check, but as soon as it arrived, he would go out and celebrate. It seems he wrote for magazines, a queer way to make a living. So let's look at the questions from this extract. Question number one. Anil made money by fits and starts. What does fits and starts mean? Deemed it fit to start investing money. Started earning money in the recent past. Received money intermittently. Put his money to use frequently. So the answer is received money intermittently. What is intermittently? Irregularly. Okay, now and then. So let's look at the next question. The information in the extract suggests that Anil could be a salaried professional, freelancer, businessman or a volunteer. So we know that he was a writer, and so the answer is B, a freelancer. So next, if borrow is equal to lend, then pick the odd pair from the options. So we know that borrow and lend are opposites, so we must look at a pair which is not opposite. So here the only answer is C, which is hop and skip. All others are opposite pairs. Now next, the reference to making a little money this way refers to what? To a way that is viewed by most of the people as sensible, inappropriate, charitable, aggressive. So here the answer is C, charitable. So let's look at the next question. Based on your understanding of Anil in the extract, choose the option that synchronizes with his thinking. So what if I don't have much money? Giving it to that person is important, as they could do with a helping hand. I better learn how to protect my money. I think I'm being looted. I earn money with such tremendous effort. Where does it all go? When I become rich, I can begin to help friends then. Right now, I will spend on myself. So according to the extract, the answer is A. So next question. Lencho compared the quantum of damage with attack by rats, attack by crows, a flock of locusts, none of the above. So he compared his damage to an attack by a flock of locusts. So let's look at the next question. What did Mandela learn about courage? It is absence of fear. It is triumph over fear, both A and B, none of the above. So the correct answer is A. B, which says that courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over fear. So the answer is B. Next question. Why does Annie think she was lonely? She had no friends. She had no real friends. She was all alone. She was an introvert. So we know that Annie had friends, but she did not have any real friends. So that is why she felt that she was lonely. So next question. What was the description of the house which Maddie thought to be Wanda's house? Little white house, big white house, small green cottage, tiny red hut. So the answer is A, little white house. How does the caged tiger react to the visitors? He ignores them with a happy face, is with a sad face, or is very proud. So we know that the tiger ignores the visitors. So next, who is the poet of the poem, the ball poem? Sylvia Plath, W.B. Yeats, Robert Frost, or John Berryman? So the poet is John Berryman. In 2 weeks, he had been transformed into a lithe, hard-muscled animal. What is the meaning of the word lithe? Dirty, graceful, misbehaving, rude. So the word lithe means graceful. What was Anil doing when the boy met him? Cooking, watching a match, playing, writing an article. So we know that when the thief met Anil, he was watching a wrestling match. Who did Griffin attack and rob all the money? The landlord, the assistants of the London store, the owner of the big London store, the owner of the theatrical company. So Griffin attacked and stole the money from the owner of the theatrical company in London. So I hope you liked today's video. For more informative videos, do subscribe to Hello English Teacher. Like, share, and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.